Majesty, the King of Norway.
Yes. Good morning, Miss Cousin. Well, nice to see you again.
It's good to see you.
Thank you, we're very kind of you.
Oh. Nice to see you.
Nicely closed.
All right. See you again, sir.
Yes, President. How are you?
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you. It's a great pleasure, sir.
Thank you.
Lobster. Come this way, sir.
So nice.
Howard Baker.
Nice to see you. I'm Howard Baker.
Colin Powell. General Powell.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you, sir. Good to see you.
Great to come to lunch. Just terrific. Good morning, Howard. How are you? Just great. Got a beautiful day going. Terrific.
I think we're just going to have a small talk.
Two waves of freshmen through.
How are you?
Two waves of freshmen.
Zoom. Nice to see you. Nice to see you.
They did have a couple of waves.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah, they'll come charging.
That's great. Water.
Still, go ahead.
Oh, here we are. You often thought of the number of pictures you get visited in the world.
Yeah, that's true.
Absolutely, okay.
You know which end of the table to get on, I see. Down here with the people.
Thank you for that.
Somebody was asking me, you know, how we were doing with the subs. And I told them that arms control in the budget negotiations would be a problem. Arms control, you get that?
Mr. President, excuse me, sir. Mr. President, how can you ask the Senate to ratify the new INF treaty when you're charging the Soviets with new violations of the 1972 ABM treaty?
I'm not going to take any questions here, but I did take that question.
If you did, what would you say, sir?
Give it to him.
I'd say a certain amount of inconsistency is justified.
On the part of the administration?
No, on the part of us who are talking to each other.
Mr. President, what do you make?
Thank you very much.
Mr. President, what do you make of Soviet television deciding to censor Gorbachev's statement about his wife being in on his decisions? Do you think there should be glasnost for a reason?
I'm going to protect myself.
Silvio, budget negotiation didn't produce very much. Might you get all fired up?
The Medici says that they got nearly the whole package put together this year.
Good. Yeah, that's right. They have no rules.
Is that why you're leaving?
No. I've got to learn to stop cutting on those guys, you know? Let me in even when I win. Going to get everything worked out?
Doors closed.
Jamie's working with you very closely.
Oh, yeah.
Listen, thank you all for coming down this morning. And I hope you all had a very nice Thanksgiving. Sorry that all of you can't have Thanksgiving in California. As you know, last month, after long and hard negotiations, the bipartisan congressional leadership, with them, we came to an agreement on a $75 billion deficit reduction package. Now, I know it isn't perfect, the agreement that came out, and I think you know the answer to that. Compromise of this magnitude, no one comes away with everything they want. But I think this agreement is a good, solid beginning. It provides the necessary service for our people. It maintains our national security, and it does both at a level that doesn't overburden our taxpayers. While efforts to cut the deficit still further must certainly continue, I think this agreement will send the right message at the right time, both to our financial markets and to governments around the world and other markets. Now for the bottom line, I need your help on this to keep our nation and economy strong and prosperous. We need to have this package adopted promptly, and I want to work with you and your leadership to make that happen. Finally, quite apart from the budget agreement itself, I want to emphasize that there are a great many problems with the continuing resolution in the House. I wrote yesterday to Bob, to the Speaker, outlining my concerns and said I would have no hesitation in vetoing the continuing resolution unless it is changed considerably. And with that, I'm going to see if Howard Baker's got something to add.
Mr. President, I had lunch yesterday with